Let's get into Pharmakeia. We've got to get into Pharmakeia. So Pharmakeia is specifically big pharma in the last days. And in the book of Revelation, it's very clear that Pharmakeia is going to play a major role across the whole earth. And in fact, that it's going to deceive the nations is what Revelation says, which we're going to get to. Revelation says that Pharmakeia is one of the tools that the devil's going to use to deceive the nations. If you don't want to be deceived, you need to know what Pharmakeia is tonight. Let's read what Pharmakeia is, and then let's read the scriptures and passages that are all about Pharmakeia. You ready? I'm ready. Drink some green tea, and here we go. Diving in. Pharmakeia. Pharmakeia is the use of medicine, drugs, or spells. Now, before I go super deep, I want to make a case. There is a difference between pharmakeia drugs and natural remedies and medicines. What is the difference? What do I mean by that? Okay, let me make this case before we even dive into this deeply. All right, the first thing is, medicines would be something like you take elderberries, which are a known potent antiviral, okay? You take elderberries and you crush them all up and you make like an elderberry syrup and you put like salt and other things in it to preserve it and help it to last longer. So you make an elderberry syrup and you make a concentrated amount and then you're able to take it in dosages. Elderberries are made by God. God made them antivirals. That's a medicinal purpose that is good and godly, and it is perfectly acceptable to take that medicine. And that is perfectly acceptable. That's not pharmakeia. That's not pharmacy. That's not this witchcraft that we're going to see in a moment, this sorcery that we see in the scriptures. What that is it's taking what God already made and you're just making it more potent, right? And then you're taking it in order to fight a virus. Another thing would be like antibiotics. That's not some weird thing made out of a concoction of chemicals and a bunch of disgusting stuff and toxins. That's actually, the first penicillin was because a cantaloupe molded. I mean, it's as simple as mold on a cantaloupe. That's where you're getting your penicillin from. So it's not wrong to take that bacteria that naturally occurs on a cantaloupe, on food itself, and then be able to concentrate it so that you can beat like a flesh-eating bacteria that's attacking a person. There's nothing wrong with that. Okay, next thing would be something like an anti-parasite. Like ivermectin occurs naturally. It's a naturally occurring medicine, and it's something that a lot of farmers use on animals, and it's used on human beings as well, and maybe you've used it with your dogs before when they've had fleas. Well, ivermectin actually occurs naturally. It's a very basic, simple compound. So I just listed some medicines that are all natural, and you've got an antiviral, you've got an antibacterial, and you've got an antiparasitic, and those all are natural medicines. Even the Bible doesn't talk badly about medicine. And in fact, the scriptures say that the word of God is like medicine unto one's flesh. Quite literally, when you read the word of God, it does actually bring healing to your flesh. That's something a lot of people today don't realize. If you will read the healing scriptures of God, it begins to build faith in you, and that leads to you receiving the healing promises of God in your life. So you've got some medicines that are all natural, but then you've got pharmakeia. And this is drugs associated with witchcraft. It's always this mixing of toxic, bad things in order to give you some sort of invincible health. And I'm going to prove this, that this is biblical. This is wild stuff. Okay, look. So pharmakeia, we already established the difference between natural medicine and pharmakeia. Okay, so pharmakeia is drugs and spells. Okay, it's the use of drugs and spells. It says medicine. Understand, it's not talking about what we were just talking about. It's talking about like what were these concoctions that we're about to talk about. Its usage in scripture is usually magic, sorcery, and enchantment. So what that means is pharmakeia gets translated into magic, sorcery, and enchantment. And that leads to people having no idea what they're actually reading. This is why I always say go to the Greek, right? Go to the Greek. Why? Because you go to the Greek and you're able to see what the actual words are. A lot of times people think that the Bible is saying first day of the week when it's actually saying Sabbath, but because the English translation says first day of the week, everybody thinks it's Sunday, but it's actually talking about Saturday. That happens repeatedly. So when it comes to pharmakeia, pharmakeia gets translated as magic, sorcery, and enchantment. And so you read it and you just think Harry Potter. You're reading it and you go, oh, they're, you know, they got sticks and they're shooting light at each other. That is not what pharmakeia is talking about. Pharmakeia is talking about the administration of drugs. An example of pharmakeia, I'll give you a low-hanging fruit, an easy one, would be like somebody cooking meth in their kitchen. So they're taking a bunch of ungodly chemicals and things that you're not supposed to put in your body, and they're making this addictive substance that gives you a high, and then they're selling it, you know, on the market. Now, that's the black magic version. There's white magic pharmakeia as well, which we're going to be talking about tonight. But white magic pharmakeia would be the kind that the whole medical industry tells you this is totally okay, and it's not okay. It's Babylonian witchcraft. So pharmakeia or pharmakeio means to administer drugs. Properly, this is drug-related sorcery, like the practice of magical arts. So it's a sorcery using drugs. Thayer's Greek lexicon gives us some other understandings. It says that pharmakeia is the use or administering of drugs. Okay, so it's very clear that that's where you get the term pharmacy from and pharmacist from. It's the administration of drugs. And it's specifically poisoning. So you're dealing with pharmakeia when you're dealing with poisonous ingredients. There's plenty of drugs in the pharmaceutical industry that are dispersed and you're told this is totally okay, and the scriptures are telling you no, it's not. Its roots are in pagan witchcraft. This is really important to understand. A drug, an enchantment. I want to take a moment to help you understand what that means. A drug, an enchantment. Oftentimes the enchantment comes and then you take the drug. What does that mean? You are enchanted by the promise of being given some sort of invincibility or some sort of ability by the drug. So you're enchanted by that promise. You're drawn in and you're just like, wow, that sounds great. And then you are tricked and you take the drug and the drug has adverse effects. So it might actually do some of what was promised to you, but because it's pharmakeia, it's witchcraft, it costs and it hurts you in some way. Notice drug dealers come along and they're like, dude, doing this drug is going to be great. So they enchant you, and then they get you to take the drug, and then the drug hooks you. The bona fide medical community does the exact same thing. The pharmaceutical companies do the exact same thing. What do? They say, look, take this drug, man. It's going to make you feel a lot better. You're going to have this ability and this ability and this. And then we take the drug, and then, oh, sorry, there's a ton of side effects. And every time you hear like a drug commercial, you hear like 58 million side effects. That's because magic costs.
This is big. A chance to live longer can cause your immune system to attack normal organs and tissues in your body and affect how they work. This may happen anytime during or after treatment has ended and may become serious and lead to death. See your doctor right away if you experience new or worsening cough, chest pain, shortness of breath, diarrhea, severe stomach pain or tenderness, severe nausea or vomiting, extreme fatigue, constipation, excessive thirst or urine, swollen ankles, loss of appetite, rash, itching, headache, confusion, hallucinations, muscle or joint pain, flushing, fever, or weakness.
So if you're going to be taking pharmakeia, it's going to cost you. That's the whole idea. God is our healer. The Bible actually teaches us to go to God in faith to be healed. Now people say, oh, that's ridiculous, Rich. No, it's not ridiculous. We literally believe in the God who told Moses to put a snake on a stick and everybody who stared at that snake would be healed of their various diseases. And the snake represented Jesus on the cross, who is despised like he were a snake or a devil. The Jews thought he was like a snake or a devil. And that's why they hung him on the pole. So when Moses does it, it points to Christ. Everybody who looks to that snake gets healed. And then Jesus teaches the same thing. The scriptures teach us that he's our healer and that he went around healing everybody. So the Bible teaches us to go to God for healing. And we can go to things like plants and stuff that he has made and are natural and not poisonous and not toxic. But this idea of mixing all this poison and all these toxins and all these heavy metals in order to produce this little pill or this shot or whatever it is, we are then taking part in pharmakeia, which is witchcraft. And it costs. And it hurts a lot of people. So pharmakeia comes from pharmakeus, can be translated pharmacist. So a person using drug-based incantations or drugging religious enchantments, a pharmakeus practitioner who mixes up distorted religious potions like a sorcerer magician that manipulate the Lord into granting more temporal gifts. Okay, so here's what pharmakeia does. It's designed to try and manipulate the Lord into granting temporal gifts. What does that mean? Look, especially invincible health and wealth. What does the drug industry, the pharma industry, offer you today? Invincible health and a richer life as a result. What are the drug companies always selling you in the commercials? You will be healthier and happier.
A chance to live longer.
Invincible health and wealth. Another term for that in today's modern scientific community would be immunity. Take this drug and you'll have immunity. Don't mind what's in it. Just take it and you'll have immunity. Folks, we are stepping into a new time, a birth pain on earth, where Pharmakeia is going to begin to play more and more of a major role, and Christians are going to be tested. And if you are still in the Babylonian Christianity, you're just going to go along with what Pharmakeia says, because Revelation says that Pharmakeia is going to deceive the nations. What does that mean? Pharmakeia is going to promise you immunity. Let us put all these toxins and these poisons into your body. Let us put a virus into your body. Let us put this bad stuff into your body, and you can have immunity. God never, never, never says inject yourself with a virus on purpose, along with heavy metals and other toxins and other disgusting things, which we're going to talk about in a moment, in order to protect you from disease. Do you know what he says? He says, repent of your sins, because sin opens the door to disease. And he also teaches, eat healthy, because that will support the immune system that God has given you. If you eat crud all day, stuff that isn't real food, stuff that's made in factories, and you're not eating stuff that grows on plants that God has made, your immune system is going to be weak. And if your immune system is weak, and then your faith is weak as well, because you're not even trusting God to be your healer, you are going to be susceptible to a lot of diseases, because you've got sin, you've got disobedience, you've got these things. And then Pharmakeia is going to come along and it's going to promise you, take this drug for invincible health. Now, just to show you a difference between Pharmakeia and actual magic, like the kind of magic you'd think of, which is like, I'm going to hold a stick and shoot some light out of my wand here. That would be translated as magius. So Magius would be like actual, like the magic arts, like a supernatural ability. Whereas Pharmakeia is the dispersion of drugs, the creation of poisonous drugs. And these drugs specifically, what did we see? They specifically promise invincible health. Revelation 18, 21 through 24 also uses Pharmakeia. The light of a lamp will never shine in you again. The voice of bridegroom and bride will never be heard in you again. Your merchants were the world's important people. By your magic spell, all the nations were led astray. So once again, we get this translation that says magic spell, and we go, oh, magic. Yeah, wow. And it doesn't click, but it's Pharmakeia. Revelation 18:23, Pharmakeia. But notice the traits that are very specific about Babylon. It says Babylon's merchants were the world's important people. So this Babylon that has the world's most important people, all the big shot merchants, they're going to use Pharmakeia to deceive the nations. And who do you see right now in the news? A businessman, and many alongside him, whole industry, a businessman promising you Pharmakeia.
A large portion of his donations have gone toward vaccine development and distribution to help ensure the vaccine is delivered to all corners of the planet as quickly as possible.
Well, we want to bring the amount of this virus in humans down to zero if possible, so that we're not constantly having to revaccinate or having outbreaks in different areas. Ideally, the whole globe would participate in this.
It's not just Bill Gates, but he's one of them. He's come along and he's one of the world important people, one of the big merchants, just like it's prophesied. And he's offering you Pharmakeia. He's deceiving you into witchcraft in the same way that Revelation prophesies that the merchants of the earth, look at how true the Bible is. The merchants of the earth, the important people, are going to lead people astray through Pharmakeia. Inject this junk into your body, and it will give you invincible health. Instead of eating in a way that God has commanded so that it supports your immune system, and instead of trusting in the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, who says, I am the Lord who healeth thee, and instead of repenting of our sins so that we can receive healing, we're instead going to witchcraft so that we can try and manipulate the Lord into giving us invincible health, even while we live in sin, while we live in doubt, while we live in rebellion, while we practice pharmakeia. We still get our invincible health.